guys, happy Sunday. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. Today I wanted to share my samples with you guys that I've been testing out for the past week. Some of them are hair care. We got a little bit of everything actually, so that's how we typically do it. I was going to describe you guys what we all have, but if you guys have been watching my Sample Sunday series, then you probably know how it works. So the first thing I have here is the MAC lipstick. So there were three different styles that I was able to test out in here. I loved all of them. I really, really love the way that they feel on my lips. I like that they kind of stain your lips a little bit. I don't have the actual package anymore because I ended up taking that with me while we traveled, and then I tossed it before we left, but I remember to keep this part so that way there I could talk about it with you guys. But I think these are so comfortable in the lips, and I can see why MAC is very popular for lipsticks, because they're just nice to wear and they don't feel so heavy on your lips. I don't like anything heavy on my lips. I don't like to feel like there's a lot of goop. So like glosses and lipsticks and things like that, I don't like anything super heavy. So sometimes I'll take a tissue and pat it off a little bit just to leave behind the stain is what I typically like. So I really enjoyed these. These were very, very nice. I would definitely say that Mocha and Velvet Teddy were my favorite colors because those two work the best for me. So they have a variety of colors you can choose from though. So don't worry, there's not just three. I'm sure you probably know that MAC has a ton of lipsticks. If you watch out for the Ulta, their semi-annual sales that they have, or what do they call it? It's like their spring and fall sales that they have, 21 Days of Beauty. So if you watch out for those sales, then you might be able to catch some MAC lipsticks on sale, because that's how I got mine on sale last time, because it was in the 21 Days of Beauty. So definitely keep your eye out for that this spring coming up. The next thing is from Clarins. This is the Extra Firming Jouer. I'm not sure how you pronounce it. Hang on, where's the actual container? Here it is. So this is an SPF 15, so I wouldn't say this is like enough SPF to use on the daily as far as like making sure you're protected, but it was a nice moisturizer. So to me, that's what I basically use it as, was a moisturizer, a day moisturizer. I would still go in with my spray SPF. You guys know I love the Ulta one. I think the Ulta one works fantastic. It's not super expensive. It smells really nice and it sets, and you don't have to put it on before makeup. You can do it after makeup. You can do it with no makeup. So it just works really well. But this was nice. I think that this worked well as like a day moisturizer. Would I purchase it? Probably not, just because SPF 15 is a little low in my opinion. I personally would want something a little bit more stronger. That way there, that's, you're covered. So I do know that you're supposed to reapply sunscreen. So even if you do put this on after you, or before you put your makeup on, make sure that you're still using like a spray sunscreen to reapply, because your SPF does wear off. So make sure we're taking care of our skin, because this is all we get. The next thing is the shampoo and conditioner. This is the Matrix Keep Me Vivid. These are really nice. I love the smell of Matrix's hair products. It sounded like I was saying it wrong for some reason. So I really love the way that Matrix smells for hair products. These didn't have any like color to them. I was kind of thinking maybe it would be like purple or something like that, but it wasn't. It was just a clear, not clear, but it was like a creamy white. And both of them worked really well. The shampoo actually had a suds to it, so I don't know if you like that or not. Me personally, I like when my shampoo has a little bit of suds. I feel like it does a better job of cleaning. I know that sometimes when they say that there's no sulfates and things like that, that that's the reason why there's no suds, but I personally like the suds. So I think it worked really well for me as cleaning my hair. It smelled very, very good. My hair dried really well, so I didn't see anything like as far as like making it look extra like shiny or anything like that. So I wouldn't say it did that. It just did a good job of cleaning. Do I think it's worth getting Matrix when they're on sale? Absolutely. I think Matrix is a really good line. So if you can catch them on sale at Ulta, like when they have their leader sale, that's when I would personally buy them. Then we have Kenra. Kenra is a brand that I absolutely love. I love their hair care stuff. This is the strengthening conditioner. It's supposed to stop breakage. After using it for a week, which only is twice of washing my hair, I didn't notice a difference as far as my hair breaking off less or anything like that. I think this is something that you would have to use a lot more consistently than two times. But I do know that I've tried things from, who was it before I did? I think it's Kenra actually too. Maybe, maybe not. I can't remember, but it was a hairline that I tried that you spray it into your hair and it helps to keep your hair from breaking off. And I know after continued use, you can see a huge difference in it. So I don't know. I mean, for using it out for 1 week, it didn't have a bad smell to it. It smelled pretty good. So I would try it a little bit more. There is more in here. Obviously, I was not able to use it all up. So I'm going to try it out some more and see if I can see if there's any difference, and I'll put it into my empties. But for now, I would say I'm kind of on the fence about it. I don't know if it helps or not. So we're going to continue to try it. The next thing is from Kiehl's. This is the Kiehl's Ultra Facial Cream. So when they say cream, it's definitely a cream. It's not a lotion. It's a lot thicker. So if you like a lot thicker lotion at nighttime, highly recommend this. Or if you're like me and you have really dry skin and you like to put a nice heavy cream on in the daytime before you put foundations on that are a little bit more drying, this works really well. This was really nice. I'm not a huge Kiehl's fan because I find that their stuff is more luxurious, but I just don't see where it's like luxurious for what reason. I'm not sure why it's so expensive. So for me, I've not really found a benefit in using Kiehl's over other brands mostly, but this was really, really nice. I love a nice thick moisturizer, and this is definitely that does the trick for me. My skin did not feel dry whatsoever, so I really enjoyed this. This was something I would definitely consider purchasing. Then we have the Anastasia lip gloss. This is actually what's on my lips right now. I wear it by itself. I was wearing it over top of lipsticks. I absolutely love this. This is going to last me a while too because this is like a decent like sample size. This is in the shade Moon Jelly. So it's got a little bit of a reflective capability to it. So you'll be able to see it's got a little bit of blue, a little bit of purple. It kind of shifts a little bit for you, which is what I like about it. Because then if you put it over top of different lipsticks, it can kind of change the shade to the lipstick without actually changing your lipstick. So it's kind of cool. You can make one lipstick look like multiple different colors of lipstick. But I really enjoy this. It's not too thick. It's not sticky. It has a nice smell to it. So for me, this was really, really nice. I would definitely purchase the full size, but even this small sample size, I've got enough that it's going to last me a while. It takes me a while to get through lip products. Lip products are hard for me to use up. I just have a hard time using them up completely. I don't know about you guys, but I just have a hard time hitting pan on those. But I did recently hit pan on, where is it at? Oh my gosh, I lost it. Oh, here it is. I did recently hit pan, so speaking of pan, I hit pan on my Fenty bronzer. So just in case you guys are panners, this is pan on my Fenty bronzer. So that makes me really happy because you guys know that I love that Fenty bronzer. I think it's absolutely fantastic. Now we have two perfume samples here. So the two perfume samples we have the Elizabeth Arden White Tea. It smells very generic. I wouldn't say that there is a specific scent to it that I would be like, oh my gosh, you're going to love this because of this, that, or the other. To me, it's just a very generic scent. So it's not anything that I personally am going to be purchasing just because I didn't find anything super unique about it. So for me, it's not something I'm going to purchase. The next one is Miu Miu. This is the Flor de Argent. This one smells really nice. It's got a more floral scent, but it's not overly powerful in my opinion. So for me, I really enjoyed this, but again, it's not anything that I felt was super unique. So again, two perfumes this week that I was like, I'm sure I could get other perfumes within my collection that I already own that would definitely dupe these out. Not really dupe them, but smell better basically. So I'm not really interested in purchasing either one of those. So both of those are not too high up on the ladder for me to purchase. But if you like floral perfumes, both of those are good choices because they're more, neither one of them are so strong that I would feel like they're super bothersome and they wouldn't cause you to have a headache unless you're super sensitive. If you're super sensitive, then maybe it might. If you're super sensitive, I would stick to more like Philosophy. Philosophy, I feel like, is a lot more toned down. So that's what I would choose. All right, let's go ahead and move on to our new samples. So I'm going to pull two perfumes. The first one here is Clean Cashmere. Ooh, I love Clean. That's another brand that I feel like is really nice and gentle. So Clean Cashmere we have as our first one. Then we have Penrose. This is the Sun Saint Penrose. Never even heard of that one. You guys have ever heard of that one before? You have to let me know if you've smelled it. I'm not going to spray any right now because I already have perfume on. And sometimes when you spray two different perfumes, you can kind of like not get the correct scent from it. So I don't want to ruin the scent that I already have. Now we're moving on to makeup. I'm going to pull two out of here. The first one is, we have something from Guerlain. This is the Lingerie Depot. This is the Natural Perfection Foundation. And the shade is 02 Claire Light. So I'm hoping this will work. If not, then I'll have to mix it in with something else. But here's a little foundation sample to try out from Guerlain. I know Guerlain, I think, is the brand that, oh my gosh, Thrift Thick. I think that's what she likes, their primer. But I'm not sure about their foundation. The next one is, oh, what is this? We have something from NARS. This is the bronzing powder. Well, how convenient. Since I'm almost out of my favorite bronzer from Fenty, we'll have to see how good this one is. See if maybe it can take a run for the money. So I have two products there to test out for this week. Then we're moving on to, we have, I think this is a skincare basket. So we have the skincare basket. I'm going to pull three out of here. The first one is, let's see. What do we got? We have This is the Fresh Black Tea Firming Eye Serum. You guys know I'm always on the hunt for something really good for under my eyes because I do have some major under eye issues. So, not really major. I just have a lot of like puffiness and it's kind of dark underneath. So, I'll have to try this out and see how good it is. The next one is, what do we have here? We have the Strivectin Advanced Retinol Intensive Night Moisturizer. So we have a new moisturizer to test out. Strivectin is a brand that I really love. So hoping I love this, but at the same time, not so much because Strivectin is quite pricey. A little pinky out here for us. The next one is, what do we have now? We have the Ulta Beauty Blueberries and Yogurt Smart Skincare Skin Balancing Superfood Mud Mask. So it says 3 to 4 uses per pouch. So that's pretty cool. That's a nice, decent size. And this would make a really good gift for somebody too. So it looks like you can buy these individually because it's got a little scanner thing on the back. So I'm excited to try that out. Who doesn't love blueberries? I love blueberries. Blueberries and strawberries and bananas. Oh my gosh, that would make a really good smoothie actually. All right, the next one is our hair and body. So I'm going to pull two out of here. The first one is, we have the Kenra Strengthening Conditioner. Well, since I'm still using the strengthening, this is the same thing. I'm going to throw this into y'all's basket, actually, then. Never mind. I thought it was a strengthening conditioner and the kind of shampoo that I had last time. Now we have the Vita Liberata. This is the Fabulous Soft Tanning Gradual Lotion. Getting ready for spring, so it's time for us to start breaking out our soft tanner. So I'm excited to try this out. You guys will have to let me know if you've tried it, which one, if you like that or not. The next thing is, we have the Wella. I'm pretty sure we've tried this recently. I know I have because this bottle looks very familiar. So I'm going to throw that into your basket. The next one is, what do we got? Oh, something squishy. We have the Alterna Caviar Replenishing Moisture CC Cream. It's a 10-in-1 correction leave-in. So it kind of sounds like it's a 10 type of product. So except for it's Alterna, which is a lot more expensive than the It's a 10. So hopefully if we like it, it does something extremely good. So we'll go ahead and throw that in there. So now we're moving on to the goodie bag from last week. This was the goodie bag. It's the little Ulta Beauty one. All of the goodie bags that I had previously are mailed out. I mailed them out on Thursday. So this is the only one that I have left right now. So if you guys are waiting for a goodie bag, I do apologize. They are on the way. So let me see if I can find the Sample Sunday video here. My voice is like really cracky. I ended up getting sick when we were at the beach. I think a lot of it had to do with the ocean air and then just being on the beach for a little too long. All right, so Sample Sunday, pull it up. I'm going to scroll it all the way to the end like we have been doing. Or the beginning, not the end. That makes more sense. All right, here. Let's see. Scroll. Okay, so we're at the beginning. Now we're going to scroll. All right, let's see. Hopefully we don't close the app like we have been doing lately. All right, and stop. The winner is Brella B. She says, loving it like always, our hashtag Sample Sunday. Hope you're having a blast at the beach. So Brella B, this is your goodie bag. I went ahead and take a screenshot so I can stick your name in this goodie bag. So Brella B, all you have to do is send me an email. My email will be listed below in the description box with your mailing address, and I'll mail out this goodie bag for you. So congratulations, Brella B. So now we're moving on to the new goodie bag. So let me pick up the basket here. I have this cute one that just came with like an Ulta order. So this is a nice bright red one. Looks perfect for like a date night. Looks like you could put quite a bit of things in here, your lipstick and things. So we're gonna put our 10 goodies in here. I have a goodie sitting on top here. I need to go ahead and just grab it off. So we're gonna start with this one. This is a pink, it's like a body sponge. I'm pretty sure, I'm not even sure what this is, to be honest. It's a Bubble Babes. I have no idea. So here's the first one. So you get a little sponge here for, that is your first goodie. The next one is, let's see, we have something from Strivectin. This is the Intensive Moisture Concentrate for Wrinkles and Stretch Marks. This stuff is fantastic. The next one is from Strivectin B. So is this the same thing? Yep, same thing. So we'll put that one back. The next one is from Belief. This is the True Cream Aqua Balm. So this one's more for like oily and normal skin. So if you have normal to oily skin, you're really gonna like that. The next one is, we have something from, who is this? Philosophy. This is the Nature in a Jar Recovery Moisturizer. So Philosophy is a brand that I kind of have like a love-hate relationship for. You'll have to let me know what you think of that moisturizer. The next one is from Mamond. This is the Petal Spa Oil to Foam. It's a cleanser for your skin, so this is actually really nice. So hopefully you enjoy that as well. The next one is from e.l.f. This is the Poreless Putty Primer. So, ooh, if you haven't tried this yet, it's very comparable to the Tatcha one. So that one is in there. Let's see. The next thing is, ooh, something big. We have something from Strivectin again. This is the Blue Rescue Clay Renewal Mask. I thought this was the one that I was just using too, but it's not. So here's a little mask for you. That's six, I think. The next one is from CoverGirl. This is the Clean Fresh Cooling Glow Stick. So here's a little glow stick. It's like a hot, not hydrating, it's like a hot highlighter is what I'm trying to say. That's seven, so three more to go, pretty sure. I know I always mess up on my numbers here, you guys. Sorry. The next one is from Chlorane. This is the Nutrition Shampoo and Conditioner. So there's that little goodie. There's eight. Two more to go, guys. Next one is, let's see, found something good in here. Let me see. Oh, what do we got here? We have the Living Proof Conditioner. This one kind of smells like pepper, but it's not as bad as I used to really hate the way it smelled, but it's kind of grown on me a little bit. And the last one is, let's see, what do we got here? We have a Milani lipstick. This is the Bold Matte, and it's in the shade I Am Brave, so it's like a bright orange here. So this is everything in the goodie bag. If you're interested in winning it, all you have to do is leave me a comment, any comment, it doesn't matter. Just as long as you hashtag Sample Sunday, and then you're entered for the giveaway, and we'll draw for this bag next week. So also, don't forget to let me know what samples you've been using. Have you been loving some new things, or are there some things that you guys want to let us notice you're clear of? Don't forget to let us know that. Thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, I'll catch you guys later.